Libraries and dictionaries are very useful, especially if you want to store multiple pieces of information at once. We actually use these everywhere. Video games, websites, and even things as simple as a little checklist app uses arrays and dictionaries. These are used for storing data in a very discrete and intuitive manner. So, if you were using the save to file behavior, instead of saving just a piece of text, you can essentially save multiple pieces of information in that one save. Oh my god, that's so cool. These are standalone behaviors. Arrays are lists. Okay, let me explain. It's great for storing things like student names in a classroom. Let's say we have an array with 3 items in it. We have Bob, Carl, and Mike. These are some random names I made up, but whatever. We can do whatever we want with this array. We can add a new value to it, delete values, replace.
What the freak replace? Oh heck no, I'm not replacing these students.
How about deleting?
Yeah, I'm not deleting students either.
Oh, what are we gonna do if Bob goes missing?
Oh no. Yeah, I'm getting fired for this.
Bro, they're gonna find out that their mascot's missing, bro. I'm so done for.
Well, you can do whatever you want with these arrays. I won't judge. And yes, arrays are like dynamic lists. They can change. Not only can we modify arrays, we can also retrieve a specific value from them. Now, arrays are ordered lists. They have something called an index. See these numbers? The first item will have an index of 0, the second item will have an index of 1, the third item will have an index of 2, and so on. We can delete the first item, and all the indexes after will have a different value. See? All the other indexes went down by 1. We can retrieve a value from a specific index using a getArrayValue behavior, and we can do whatever we want with it. You would use this to store lists of things, like maybe you want to keep track of what items you have in your inventory. There is also a getArrayCount behavior that counts how many things are inside an array, and there is also a sortArray behavior if you wanted to sort the order of an array numerically, alphabetically. You could even shuffle it all up or reverse it. Well, how about dictionaries? Dictionaries are just like arrays. In fact, they're technically the same thing. But instead of having numeric indexes, they have predefined text as their indexes. Oh, and we call these keys instead of indexes. That's what the K stands for here.
Cha-cha-cha-chia.
That starts with a C, idiot.
Cha-cha-cha-chia.
Chia pet, the pottery that grows. It's fun and easy.
So instead of index of 0, we can use name for the key. Dictionaries make it easy to store and retrieve multiple specific properties. So if you delete a key value, all the other keys are guaranteed to reference the same value. Unlike in arrays, when you delete a value, all the indexes after will change what value it is referencing. And just like arrays, you can use an index or a key to retrieve a specific piece of information from a dictionary using the getDictionaryValue. Now, the cool thing about this is that you can save and load these. Arrays and dictionaries can be represented as text, just like this. We call this JSON, without the A. Yeah. Or JavaScript Object Notation. You may have seen this format before when you were browsing data inside of a game or when the HyperPet Hub decides to be weird. Yep, that's JSON! Without the A. You can copy and paste this text and put it anywhere else you like. Share it with other people. Save it to memory. Do crazy stuff with it. What this means is that you can store multiple things at once, in one go. You can also have nested dictionaries and arrays. That means you can put an array and dictionary inside of each other. There are behaviors for manipulating arrays and dictionaries as I kept showing throughout the entire video. They take in an array or dictionary, make changes to them, and outputs the resulting array or dictionary. You've probably noticed that when referencing an array or dictionary in these behaviors, you have an option between choosing a value or the behavior. The value input allows you to put any JSON text into it, and it'll be treated like an array or dictionary. When using the behavior input, it will use the contents of that behavior. So doing either would essentially do the same thing
and would output the same thing too. The only difference is that when using a behavior instead of a value, any modification will be applied to the behavior, so the contents of it will change. I hope you now realize the amazing power that you have when you know about arrays and dictionaries. You can literally store a bunch of data into one single piece of text. So screw having multiple saves, we can just have one single save that has everything in it. Woo! And of course, if you have any questions, you can comment down below or join us in a Discord server. And I hope that you enjoyed this video and learned something new, because this is really powerful when you know what to do with it. And if you like this video, well, leave a like, of course, and subscribe! And I will see you later. Thank you.